And we begin today with new exclusive details into a story the I-team broke almost 2 weeks ago. The FBI is now investigating several officers in the West Bank Major Crimes Task Force amid allegations they illegally took money from a suspected drug dealer. We first showed you this exclusive video in late January. It shows undercover narcotics officers entering the home of Stefan Daigle in the French Quarter in January of 2011. Daigle had just been arrested at his Mid-City art studio and charged with possession with intent to distribute methamphetamine. Documents obtained by the WDSU I-team show cops had permission to search Daigle's art studio, but not his home. And because of this video, the district attorney dropped the charges against Daigle and opened an investigation into the task force officers involved. Now the feds have stepped in.
It was important for us to contact the FBI to talk to them about this. It's really no timetable. I can't predict how long or how short their investigation will take.
They can coordinate getting what? Information on these guys from NOPD, from Gretna and other jurisdictions, where if it was just NOPD doing it, they got a DA's office, then they got to go to a JP and other people to do it as well. So here they can bring it all together in the Eastern District and prosecute it as one.
And WDSU I-team reporter Travers Mackle is here with us now. So tell us what this task force is and what's happening with it now.
Well, the task force is still in operation. It's basically run out of the Gretna Police Department. It includes police officers from New Orleans, Gretna, West Wego, Plaquemines, and the Jefferson Parish Sheriff's Office. Highly successful unit, 700-plus arrests. Arthur Lawson, the chief in Gretna, tells us this is the first complaint, but the West Bank Major Crimes Task Force is operational and out on the streets right now.
So why are the feds interested in this?
Well, the feds have been interested in a lot of police misconduct or possible police misconduct issues over the last several years. There could be possible federal crimes. The feds like to use misprision of a felony, knowing about a crime and not reporting it, or possibly police officers depriving a citizen of their civil rights. Those are charges they've held on cops or hung on cops in the past. No alleged wrongdoing yet, but the feds are looking into this, and those are things that they could pursue eventually.
And the next step, I guess, have the cops hired lawyers yet?
We know at least one cop has been in contact with a defense attorney. We hear that several others could be, but we know that at least one of these police officers has hired a defense attorney in this matter.
And now what about the suspect?
The suspect is free. Leon Canizaro, as we mentioned, dropped the charges against him, so therefore he is free to go. They could pick up the charges at any time, but given this videotape and the investigations that are going on, highly unlikely.
All right, Travers, thanks.